I think improvisation would not be the same without him. I mean, there were a lot of groups in that late 60s or mid 60s, whenever it was, like the committee. I think there were groups like that in other places, but he kept doing the work and changing the forms for so long. He definitely shaped improvisation, and there's a definite breed of improviser and sketch comedian that was influenced by him and still strives to do work that would please him were he to ever see it.
I never got to work with Del. I know that he donated his skull to the Goodman Theater, which is great. He gives the ultimate head that way, which is... I heard stories about him living under the committee, which was great.
Did you spend a lot of time watching improv at the committee?
I used to see them, and a guy named Gosling Trauma was the piano player. And I used to see all those guys. I was in the experimental wing of the committee.
Rob, it's a class there too.
Oh yeah, there was like workshops, which were great. It was the best. Where are you from, Chicago?
Well, New York and San Francisco.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Is that where you learned about improv?
No, I learned about that in life, basically. But I took an improv class at college. Oops. Oh, look at that.
Class was, it is always such a nervous experience, but especially with him, you really got the feeling that if you got anything out of him, you would accomplish something for the class, because it was so hard to tickle his funny bone, to inspire him, like I said, just because he'd been around.
Because it was something about Eraserhead or something, that movie. So I came out like, I mean, I was trying to be Eraserhead. And so I came out, or whatever. And he's like, stops everything. He's like, well, what's your name? And I was like, Rachel. I could feel the impending doom. He's like, yeah, that's the kind of thing we do. That's the kind of thing they do over at Players Workshop, which is like, you know, the highest of insults. And I didn't know anyone in class, and I feel like my face turning bright red, and I was just like, gulp.
I was in some like basic, you know, doctor, patient, nurse, some kind of really basic improv scene, and he asked us, what was that scene about? What do you think that scene was about? And we were like, the conflict between the... And they let us hang around. And he's like, no, it was a scene about bad improv. Just like, vicious, just like burn people. And he basically just insulted everyone and sort of broke them down that first day.
Joan, how important is improvisation to what you do?
Everything.
Let's
go. Okay.
Well, one thing people say about Del was that he was misogynist, he didn't like women, and what do you think about that?
I don't think Del liked anybody. And I think, I don't know, because I think, obviously, he was so good to Sharna over the years, and they were so close. And I think Del didn't like bad improvisers of a very specific sort, which was, I was saying, like, soft, timid, cute, which probably more bad women improvisers might fall into that category, whereas the bad male improvisers would maybe more likely to fall into the category of never shutting up, entering every scene, trying to be funny, so maybe if that irritated him less, he'd probably still shut that person down. But so I think, and he criticized people openly, so you could, everyone puts that through their own filter, and if that made, if you were a woman and he told you you sucked, you might be like, he hates women, but you probably need to explore the idea that maybe you do suck. Like,
there was one kid that came along that had a friend of his in from out of town, and apparently, you know, he thought, well, I don't know, I'm going to show you, but this, you know, could he sit in with class with Dell? So, well, I don't know, I'm check with Dell. Apparently he didn't, because the kid was sitting in there with Dell, and Dell looked up and he saw this stranger in there, and he immediately started making comments about how, well, I see we have someone uninvited in here. I see this is, how effing rude is this? And I think they were scared to move, actually.
Wow.
And then finally, Dell just turned in a fury, just shouts, F off, turkey! And he didn't say F. And everyone in the room froze. They were terrified. And thank God they up and left. But wow. Dell could invoke terror. But he also inspired you to do your best work.
I think persistence and having like that flame under you to try new things and being inspired when you see someone crash and burn and fail. And I know Dell took a sense of delight in seeing people fail and watching them struggle on stage, and the value of that, which no one seems to walk away from a show when they had a hideous show thinking like, oh, that was a good thing. But I think there is value in it.
He could have just like shamed me out of improv. Like, I wonder how many people just like quit because they thought they sucked. And, you know, he was like pretty harsh. But if you made it through there, then I guess you're never going to, like, face that again.
Anybody that he derailed, it was probably good that he did. Because if you can do it, you can... If you can do it, you can do it in those circumstances.
Great.
What other things about Dell have you heard?
Well, I've heard a lot about Dell. He used to roller skate with a miner's helmet.
And he built a spider's nest under the committee when he lived under there for a while. Yeah. The original Spider-Man was built. And also living in the sewers in Chicago, he had rat hunting for those who were willing.
On and off stage, it takes a lot of strength to follow the fear instead of fighting the fear.
How did you enjoy being a Compass Players when you were younger?
I wasn't a Compass Player, I was a Second City Player. But it was the same thing, but later.
No, but that is the thing, that is the thing that I kind of always do think that you learn from Dell, because forms, you learn forms and you learn different things, but he was really the one that if you learn not to try to be cute in your work, and if you were ever cute as opposed to truthful, he would ream you, he would be so viciously cruel afterwards that it broke you of it. And I'm very grateful.
And then, and like now you look around and, you know, most everyone is doing really cool things that are on a national level and being seen by everyone. So it's really cool when you think back, like just looking around and like, well, I think this person's really funny. And then to know like, oh, well, so does America.
Oh yeah, the cult of Dell, it should be the Church of Dell, Our Lady of the Ultimate Herald.
So much of the best comedy in the last half of the 20th century stems from Dell, either directly or indirectly. There's usually a way to trace it on back and find that Dell had his fingers in there somewhere or another. Whether it was performers, whether it's writers, whether it's directors even, Dell was involved somehow, and his influence is only going to grow as time goes on.
Did you get along with Dell kids very well?
Who cares? It's dead.
Pop it, pop it, pop it, pop it, pop it, go to motorcycle.